أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
We have another narration from Wa'il ibn Hujr, narrated by Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba, volume 1, page 390. An Alqamah ibn Wa'il ibn Hujr, an Abihi Wa'il ibn Hujr, قال رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يضع يمينه على شماله تحت السرة. I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam placing his right hand on his left below the navel. Hafiz Qasim ibn Qutlubugha says in Takhrij Ahadith al-Ikhtiyar Sharh al-Mukhtar, هذا إسناد جيد. وقال العلامة محمد أبو الطيب المدني في شرح الترمذي, هذا حديث قوي من حيث السند. وقال المحقق عابد السندي في طوالع الأنوار, رجاله ثقات. So, this narrator over here is Wa'il ibn Hujr, from whom Ala Sadrihi was narrated by Muhammad ibn Ismail. However, in this second narration, which is narrated by Imam Abu Bakr ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf, he narrates that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam placed his right hand on his left hand below the navel. This is direct narration from Wa'il ibn Hujr. So on one hand, that athar was narrated by Muhammad ibn Ismail only, and his condition is known. He was a lone narrator, and all his classmates said alal yusra and full stop, and he added ala sadrihi, that above the chest. And over here, another narration from Wa'il ibn Hujr says that يَضَعُ يَمِينَهُ عَلَى شِمَالِهِ تَحْتَ السُّرَّةِ. And Qasim ibn Qutlubugha said, إِسْنَادٌ جَيِّدٌ. Abu Tayyib al-Madani said, حَدِيثٌ قَوِيٌّ مِنْ حَيْثُ السَّنَدِ. جَيِّدٌ سَنَدْ and قَوِي سَنَدْ. And Abid al-Sindi rahmatullah alayhi said, رِجَالُهُ ثِقَاتٌ. The narrators of Ibn Abi Shayba's Athar and Hadith are Siqa. So rather than bringing forward another narration, we have the same Sahabi, Wa'il ibn Hujr, narrating below the navel. And there are other ahadith also which say below the navel. For example, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu narrates, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu says, ثَلَاثٌ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النُّبُوَّةِ تَعْجِيلُ الْإِفْطَارِ وَتَأْخِيرُ السُّحُورِ وَوَضْعُ الْيَدِ الْيُمْنَى عَلَى الْيُسْرَى فِي الصَّلَاةِ تَحْتَ السُّرَّةِ. Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri has narrated this in his Al-Mahalla, volume 3, page 35. Three things are from the characteristics of prophethood: doing the iftar early and delaying the suhoor and placing the right hand on the left in salah beneath the navel. Number 3, Uqba ibn Suhban says he heard Ali karamullah wajhu say with regards to فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ, he said, وَضْعُ الْيُمْنَى عَلَى الْيُسْرَى تَحْتَ السُّرَّةِ. This author is narrated by Imam Ibn Abdul Barr al-Maliki rahmatullahi alayhi in his At-Tamheed, volume 2, page 78. Number 4, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says, أَخْذُ الْأَكُفِّ عَلَى الْأَكُفِّ فِي الصَّلَاةِ تَحْتَ السُّرَّةِ. The holding of the hands upon hands in salah is below the navel. Narrated by Imam Abu Dawood rahmatullahi alayhi in his Sunan, in the Nuskha of Ibn al-Arabi, volume 1, page 280, also by Imam Ibn Hazm in his Al-Muhalla, volume 3, page 30. Number 5. حجاج بن حسان says, سمعت أبا مجلز أو قال سألته قال قلت كيف أضع؟ قال يضع باطن كف يمينه على ظاهر كف شماله ويجعلهما أسفل من السرة. Narrated by Imam Ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf, Volume 1, page 391, and his وَإِسْنَادُهُ صَحِيحٌ. The isnad of this athar is sahih. Abu Mijraz was asked that how should I tie my hands, and he said, put the palm of your right hand over the zahir of your left hand and put them below the navel. And then the athar of Sayyiduna Ali ibn Abi Talib karramallahu wajhahu, wherein Sayyiduna Ali ibn Abi Talib karramallahu wajhahu says, من السنة وضع الأكف على الأكف في الصلاة تحت السرة. This is narrated by Imam Abu Dawood rahmatullah alayhi in his Sunan in the Nuskha of Ibn al-Arabi, Volume 1, page 280. Narrated by Imam Bayhaqi in his Sunan, Volume 2, page 31. Also Musnad Ahmad, Volume 1, page 1110. Also Musannaf Ibn Abi Shayba, Volume 1, page 391. Also Daraqutni, Volume 1, page 286. Now, when a Sahabi says, مِنَ السُنَّةِ كَذَا وَكَذَا, then whose Sunnah does he mean? Above Sahabi is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If I was to say today that مِنَ السُنَّةِ كَذَا وَكَذَا, then there could be Sunnah of those before us, our Salafu Salihun. If Tabi'i Tabi'in or Aima were to say مِنَ السُنَّةِ, they might mean the Sunnah of Tabi'in, Sunnah of Sahaba. But when a Sahabi says من السنة كذا وكذا, then above him is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He means this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ali is Ali. He is Madinatul Ilm. Ana Madinatul Ilm wa Aliyun Babuha. Babul Ilm. So Sayyiduna Ali karramallahu wajhahu was a very learned person, and he knew Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very well. And he is saying over here that it is from sunnah that you place your hand upon hand in salah below the navel. Keeping these athar and hadith in mind, Imam Abu Hanifa and Imam Ahmad's more preferred version is to place the hands below the navel. And also some other athar as well narrated from other sahabas and tabi'in like Ibrahim Nakhai rahmatullahi alayhi, who used to say يَضَعُ يَمِينَهُ عَلَى شِمَالِهِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ تَحْتَ السُّرَّةِ. عن إبراهيم النخعي أنه كان يضع يده اليمنى على يده اليسرى تحت السرة. These are تابعين. They saw the Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين placing them below the navel. This is why Imam Ibn Qudama الحنبلي رحمة الله عليه writes in المغني وروي ذلك عن علي وأبي هريرة وأبي مجلس والنخعي والثوري وإسحاق بن راهوي لما روي عن علي رضي الله عنه من السنة وضع اليمين على الشمال تحت السرة رواه الإمام أحمد وأبو داود وهذا ينصرف إلى سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That this placing the hands below the navel has been narrated from سيدنا علي, سيدنا أبو هريرة, سيدنا أبو مجلز, إبراهيم النخعي, سفيان الثوري, إسحاق بن راهوي. It has been narrated by Imam Ahmad and Abu Dawood, and this is the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, a person should place his hands below the navel in salah.
محمد رسول الله محمد رسول الله أرجو رضاك يا الله أنت الرحيم يا الله